Hello guys, welcome back to another video. So it's been a while, sorry about that, but the good thing is we are back. So one of the days recently, Joe Rogan mentioned my name and my channel in one of his recent episodes, and because of that there is new people coming in, and I appreciate all of you curious people coming around here to see what I'm all about and what I believe in. It's quite different, probably, from other things you've heard. I assume that you might be interested in old civilizations, history, Tartaria, stuff like that. Because you're here, and if that's the case, you're at the right place, so that's good. So before I start explaining these photos here, first of all, I have my reasons to believe what I believe in. That's me. I don't know what you believe in, and it's up to you to think for yourself if this makes sense or not. And also, I want you to put all previous belief systems that you have to the side just for this video. Just forget about them for a little bit and watch this video and look closely to the photos as I explain with a new set of eyes, without any previous thoughts that you have about these structures, etc. Okay, so that's all. Let's dive into it. So I believe the past civilization were here, established here possibly for thousands of years, but then suddenly a cataclysmic event happened in this earth realm. So what I think is the past civilization built this earth very similar to a circuit board in a computer, you could say, and the buildings acted as the components on this free energy grid that they had. But this cataclysmic event, I believe it was electrical, and because the buildings were components, they got short-circuited or overloaded with electricity, which caused them to overheat and melt. So that's what I think. And yeah, let's take a look here. So here is one structure, and this is what we call a pocket of survival, because there is still remnants of the structure here that is very easily, obviously, recognizable as a structure. But you can see how it's fused into this formation here. And here is the unusual part, because I believe this is also part of the structure, okay? I don't think this is a naturally generated formation. I think this is part of the structure, but it got melted. And when you melt stuff, you get altered states of matter, which will change the appearance and properties of said matter. So you can see this, it's very unnatural to build like this, in my opinion. So this is a little pocket of survival here. And here you can see all of this. I believe these were red bricks originally. But again, when you heat stuff to a certain amount, they will change. So they changed into what they would call rocks now, right? In so-called geology. I don't think geology is a thing, okay? I think the lies we're told in this place is enormous, and they go deep, okay? So yeah, just keep listening. So here is another one again. How can this be a naturally generated formation here? So to me, it looks like it used to be some kind of wall structure. It's obviously very, very damaged. It looks like this now, but you have this pocket of survival here still. So a little bit of it still is recognizable as a structure. But I don't think this is natural at all. I don't think plate tectonics can just do this, right? They tell us about plate tectonics and they're pushing stuff and and that creates all these formations that we have. But I think that's a lie, okay? So here is another one. To me, this one screams melted. And again, I know at school, etc., when we were little naive kids, we were confused, clueless, and we were naive because we thought, oh, we're going to school to learn something. But what really happened is we got indoctrinated. And that's not the teacher's fault. Don't blame the teacher that you had, because your teacher was also indoctrinated, and the teacher is teaching what he or her was taught when he or her was a child, okay? So this whole cycle that we're in here, this endless cycle of indoctrination, just keeps going and going and going until we humans start to break the cycle and start thinking for ourselves. And that's what I'm doing here, and that's hopefully what you're doing. And at some point, hopefully, enough of us can know what's going on, and then we can change things, you know. That's one of my dreams that I have. If it's gonna happen in my lifetime or not, I don't know. But at least I can try. That's why I'm making these videos, and that's why you're watching this video. So here is another one. Melted structure, they call it mountains now. I don't think mountains is a thing. And you can see here, if you go into the details, you can see this one, 90 degree angle, very straight here and here. And then there is still block work in here, doors. And here is an opening. So, you know, how do you get up here? There is like questions you gotta ask. Are you supposed to have like a ladder and go, you know? It's just kind of crazy to me how we are told that Ooga Booga cavemen carved this stuff into here or chiseled whatever. But these people, they had stuff to do all the time. You know, you gotta not go to the grocery store like we do now in the current civilization. That's also very unnatural, by the way. But you gotta gather food. You gotta, sometimes you gotta poop or take a shit. And then are you gonna shit inside your cave all the time and piss inside there and make a hellhole for yourself, you know? And then here, more pockets of survival, brickwork here. But then you see this detail suddenly, like, okay, so if you're just a caveman trying to survive the elements, why would you need to carve this extra stuff here? You know, it doesn't make sense to me. And here, is this a failed attempt to make a house? And yeah, I mean, it just looks like a melted structure to me. What do you think? This one is a great one, because you can see the mangled melt. You can see the pockets of survival. Also notice how a lot of these supposed carved openings or chiseled openings are like archways. That's because originally they built it with red bricks, and the archway is one of the strongest structures that we have, you know. An arch, they usually are very strong and they never collapse, and there is plenty of evidence of that as well. But take a look over here. So what is this supposed to be? Say, if they carved or chiseled this, why would they do this? I mean, this had to take like a lifetime, right, to do this for no reason. It's like useless. And then you can see the straight thing here, part of the structure. You can see a little bit of brickwork here, or now it's rocks and blocks because they changed, but you know what I mean. And then here you can see how straight it is, and then suddenly you see this thing. So this is the pocket of survival here. You can see stairs here, and then here you have this issue again. I mean, how the hell do you like get in here and out and go for groceries and, you know, all that stuff? Are you just sitting in your cave all day? Just sit there? And then occasionally you go out, you kill a deer, you go inside and have a campfire, you eat, and then you just sit there for 15 hours until bedtime? I mean, didn't people do anything during the day? And then, of course, there's another photo, but here you see this. Part of the structure, guys. Part of this whole structure, but it got mangled here, of course. But this one, Pocket of Survival, and there is some more stuff here. I got another photo of the same place here. So you can see this one fused into the supposed mountain. But it is a Pocket of Survival, and here, this again. Very interesting place. I'd say this is a melted structure as well. And here, similar stuff, might be in the same area. By the way, if you want to find these places for yourself, just screenshot and reverse image search them. I'm not going to bother editing and, you know, remembering all the names and putting the name on the photos, etc. You can just screenshot and reverse image search. It's pretty easy. But here, more apertures in this melted structure. Big openings up here and here. Doors and windows and archways, whatever they used to be. Stairs. Something down here as well. And then the rest around it turn into that. So there is different kinds of melt in this video. There is some pictures that's easy to see, some that's more difficult, but I'm gonna show a little bit of everything, and hopefully, yeah, like I said, it will make sense to you in a way. So here is another one. This one is in better condition than the one we just saw, because you can still see a lot of these details that they had. And there is still structure standing with the same design from the same people, probably. But for some reason, during the cataclysm, they were not struck as hard as this one. So this one is just fused into, and you know, you call it a mountain now, but it's not. It's a structure. The whole thing is, this is a structure here. You got some of this beautification here. This is just concrete molds that they attach to the exterior of these red bricks. It's pretty simple. There's no carvings or chiseling or whatever they say. So you can see a little bit faint design here. There's some people here as well. And here. And again, if you're trying to just hide from the elements, why do you do this stuff here? And all that stuff. For aesthetics, I mean, you're a fucking Ooga Booga caveman. What do you know about aesthetics, right? You don't even know what's on the other side of the village, apparently, according to what they tell us. And what's this? Is this supposed to be? So, yeah, you can see the structure here. So, it melted. Altered states of matter. Red bricks, mortar. They had concrete. And all that shit got mangled. And now this is what it looks like. See here, what's this? Why would a caveman come here and carve this? Does it make sense to you? Here, similar. I believe this is in Greece. And yeah, I mean, when I say fried, just look at this. This looks fried to me. And you can see some of the brickwork up here turn into rocks, blocks, but you still have bricks in here. You still have some of the red bricks that didn't change. You see? I'll show you some crazy ones. Here's a video. I can't zoom on this one. Hopefully you can see it. But look, this is all heat expansion and damage here. All this stuff, swelling, expansion. here, the window archway, you can see the red brick survived. I believe that is because, hold on. So because there is no material here, there was less electricity going through this area right here, because it's just an opening, and that's why it was less heat just around this archway. We see that all the time, that openings and archways like this usually are still red brick while everything around changed. But look, this is all swelling. Nobody built on top of this ugly stuff right there. Okay, that's what they would tell you, right? But they gotta make up these lies to deceive us. And they can just put up like a little poster on these sites and come with some bullshit narrative and say, okay, for 2,000 years ago, this guy and that guy came here and they built this castle, and just forget about it. And then after you read that, you're just like, okay. And then you move on with your life. You don't even think about it, you know. It's pretty easy now these days for these parasites to keep deceiving us. Here is a very good one, where you can see the pockets of survival all over the place, but it's in the supposed mountain again. You can see it's been so heat damaged around here, but you have a little bit that's still here. Look here, a window here, part of this, some here, obviously part of this. So what's that around here? And here a wall, window, and then you get this one too, fused into that, which is the building itself. And here, so this is what we call a rock curtain. So you can look at the swelling here, by the way. So you can see here it goes like that, and then it just expands and gets swollen from the heat. But yeah, this is what we call a rock curtain. So this whole thing here was viscous, high viscosity, moving slowly, melting down on the buildings under. And then the event stopped and it densified, and now you have this building that's being, you know, kind of buried halfway. Hold on, there is another photo, I believe. Yep, this is a little bit better to see here, a little bit better quality. You can see more here that the structure is being buried by this swollen, melted, huge ass building mass here. So this is part of the building. You can see the horizontal lines. That's what they call sedimentary lines, etc. Just nonsense. It's actually brick lines. Okay, bricks are horizontal. So this is remains of the brick lines. Swollen sometimes, expanded into block lines, etc. But that's why you have these horizontal lines all over the place. It's a good deception, they tell us. It is. I believed it for 24 years of my life or so. Then I came across some meltology videos and I was like, oh damn, okay. Yeah, this makes way more sense. Just think about it. So here's another example of the archway here. Red bricks surviving while most stuff around it here turned into that, into rocks. So basically there is no geology, there is no rocks, there is no mountains, there's also no caves. I will show you some photos. So the caves are the internals of this melted structures, the internals that didn't collapse completely into just one huge chunks. There's still passageways and hallways and shit and stuff inside. But yeah, I mean, they had access to bricks. So, I mean, which bricklayer would do this? Let's put some random bricks in here. We need big rocks. Now let's use some bricks. Some bricks here, some big rocks. I mean, this is obviously heat damaged. And here is a nicer... to the right here, a little bit better condition here, this one. So these bricks, the way they used to make them, I believe they were conducting electricity. They could possibly be used as batteries as well to store electricity. And here, okay, so you see the weird patterns here, how you have some bricks and then a layer of these stupid rocks and bricks, and you know, you see this pattern. This is what I mean with electrical current surging through in specific ways in this circuit board component buildings, mangling the buildings and bricks in specific ways. Okay, does that make sense? So for some reason the electricity was surging through here and in the middle and through here and here, but not as much here, you know. I don't know how it works, and it is a cataclysmic event, so we can't replicate it on a smaller scale because it's a cataclysm. How do you do that, you know? But you can still see a lot of the bricks. This, again, I mean, which bricklayer would do this? Just jam some random stuff in there. I mean, it makes no sense. So that's what I think with these patterns, the electricity going through here. You know, on my computer and stuff, I don't know exactly where the electricity goes a little bit more than other places and stuff in my processor and graphics card and stuff. But whatever these buildings were and however they functioned, it's similar to that, I think. If that makes sense. I don't know. I'm trying to explain the best I can based on what I think and believe at this point. This one obviously screams melted to me. And yeah, they will say wind and water erosion. But like I said, they had to explain it somehow so you don't think about it. But what if it's easier? What if it's just simply melted? And they have to like, oh shit, they can't know that it's melted buildings. Because if we do, then we understand that there was a very high technology civilization before us. And then you will realize what was taken from us and what was hidden from us. And that should make you a little bit pissed at the establishment and the parasites and the controllers. If you know what I mean. That's why this is important. So here you see internals of these structures. This is what they will call caves. They will call it mines and, you know, whatever they call it. But it's just internals of buildings. And here you can see the mangled brickwork. You can see all these archways and bricks and structures still in here. There's a couple of photos from this area here. You see more archways here, pillars, brick, mangled bricks. Okay. And here, columns, archways still. You see the walls here, but they're mangled, of course. And here, more archways and stuff. I mean, why the hell would you do that if you're just going in here, digging in and stuff? Why would you build a whole archway like that up here with this mangled ass bricks? Here's a pile of bricks and rocks. You can see these horizontal lines again, expanded brick lines. Here, some crazy brickwork up here. Lower archway here. Columns, more brick archways going that way, ton of archways here. That's what they did to build these structures. Here again, okay, so here another example of very bad brickwork. Just kidding. Cataclysm building. You can see bricks, rocks all over the place. And I don't think anyone built like this. Something happened to this building is what I think. So what do you see? What do you think when you see that? I mean, obviously, you know, you can see this beautification and stuff. They obviously knew how to make stuff beautiful and put some extra effort into it, but that's not beautiful. It's disgusting. So, mangled buildings. Here is one, I think this is called the Sphinx or however you pronounce it in Australia. And this one too. Obviously, it's not a naturally generated formation. I'll show you a couple of more photos. I think I got three from this place. So this one screams fried and melted as well. Some kind of structure, something happened to it. You can see this piece here, obviously man-made. And then some pillar, and you got this weird stuff here. Whatever it is, here you got one piece. Same. And here, this one is very mangled. And here, it's not a natural formation, guys, obviously. But it looks like that. So to me, it looks like some kind of structure with pillars and some kind of designs, whatever used to be here. It's very destroyed. And it melted and sunk down and collapsed down on itself during the emulsification, and then it densified, and now people think it's either a natural formation or that somebody, some caveman, Ooga Booga guy came and carved it. Here you can see the electrification from the bottom. Oh, it's a little bit corny, this photo, but you can see the bottom, the heat swelling and expanding and melting the bottom of these structures here. You see the swelling while the top is still a structure, but it's been heat damaged. Most of them were. And here is this, a random little pocket of survival in the middle of nowhere. And of course you can just say, oh, well, that's a bridge. I mean, look at it. And again, you can see the archway here, the bricks still remaining as bricks, as usual. You can see the horizontal lines in here melt. So it's part of the whole building here, but they survived for some reason. Here, just a random supposed mountain. You see these openings again. That's apertures, which is doors, windows, openings for whatever they used, that's still there. And there's a huge one up here. Just a bunch of melts, guys. Here. So, what happened here? So they built this while they were at work, and then what happened here? Is that the new guy at the brick company doing that, and they approved it? Like, oh yeah, that's good enough. I mean, see, they can obviously put bricks perfectly together here, archways, and look at all this stuff, and then that. Is that erosion? Is that wind and rain doing that? Turning red brick buildings into a pile of shit? And why didn't they do it here? And straight down, look how selective it is. Straight down. So it goes from that to that in a straight line down here into that, okay? Heat damage, cataclysm. Okay? So it's mangled now. Same thing, very cooked out, this one. Extremely mangled building. You can see the mortar, you can see the bricks turned into that. And here it's just, look at the melt. Turn into rocks, and yeah, it's fucked, basically. This structure here is fucked. I don't think rain or wind did this, guys. And here, so another supposed mountain. But look here, brick lines, a little bit wavy. Did some weird stuff here, sunk down. Looks like it tipped over a little bit, so the brick lines are not straight anymore. The building sunk down and tipped over. But this is what we call melted brick lines. Expanded brick lines, pancake brick lines, spaghetti brick lines, sometimes if they go like all over the place, they do that too. But they say sedimentary layers, forget about questions, you know, don't ask questions. another pocket of survival here, and the structure here completely destroyed. Then you got a little bit of structure here. It's a little bit unclear here, sorry about that, but yeah, you got a little bit here with some red bricks and some rocks inside. The rest, look how straight it is here. So yeah, I mean, this event is very weird. It's very unusual probably for you to hear about this kind of stuff, but there is plenty of people out there talking about this. I'm just one of them. Yeah, it makes sense. Hopefully it makes sense to you too. There is thousands and thousands of people who believe this stuff, this meltology these days, and there's a reason for it. Look, so here we drive here, and then without knowing it, you drive over this stuff, archway, archway, archway. So you drive on top of melted buildings. So that's the weird part. We, this cataclysm came, fucked everything, and then we came in as possibly the second humanity or second civilization. I don't know, but say the first civilization was here for a long time. They got cataclysmed and they all got fried. They died and melted under us and stuff. And then we come in and we just build on top of this melted shit, and we don't even know it. So here again, you see these archways, and that's, you always see the archways. So every place in the whole realm, this Ooga Booga caveman decided to carve into the supposed mountain, and they all decided to do it with an archway here. Think about that. Does that make sense? They all are like, oh yeah, I'm gonna carve in here to have this little 1 meter deep hole so I can be in here and live there, Makes no sense. So here you have more openings. These are square, but still more archways. Archway here that you can even go through here. I mean, what the fuck is the purpose of that? You can see the bushes on the other side. So you'd spend a lifetime to carve this so you can crawl under here. I mean, it makes no sense, guys. Here again, archways. Archway collapsed. Melted structures. Very mangled, this one. Another one swallowed by the melts, which is this on top here. So this one too goes in here. Here goes into the melt. The melt came from above, melting down slowly, very thick. I imagine that at least. It was very thick, slow moving, like thick walks, melting down slowly, swallowing everything below in its path. And then the event stopped for some reason. I know the flood that everybody have heard about is part of this event, possibly as a fail-safe mechanism or whatever they did. They flooded this place to try to stop the heat and preserve what could be preserved, or God did it, whatever God is. I don't believe in the biblical God. The same way, like literally whatever they say in the Bible and stuff. I think God is a part of the whole. I think this tree is part of God. And I think I am part of it. You're part of it. Your dog is part of it. The fish are part of it. I think everything alive is part of the whole, which is God. I don't think it's a bearded guy in the sky. But that's me. That's what I believe. You don't have to believe the same as me if you don't want to. But that's a different thing. So here, another pocket of survival. Very cooked out. So bricks turn into that. This one fused to the supposed mountain here. And I would say this is like archways and stuff, but they're all melted and collapsed. So kind of beyond recognition. It just collapsed. It's a huge melted structure right there. And here, this is fun. So here, this is a pretty huge cliffside right here. So, okay, boys. Let's get some ropes, hang down on the cliffside, carve some squares we can live in. Let's carve a city into the cliffside, boys. Okay? Alright. And then you carve this shit in here. And then you're in here. And then you're gonna fucking climb down. Gotta get groceries. Gonna climb down somewhere or climb up the rope all the time. And then are you gonna put your ass out of here and just shit down on the guy that lives here? He's gonna be mad at you. And there's gonna be a lot of shit down here that's gonna smell. What about this guy and this guy? I mean, all these people on here, they're just shitting down here and it piles up. And then, yeah, it's just a multi-structure. I'm just fucking with you guys, okay? So, yeah, just apertures, pockets of survival. Nobody carved any of this shit, okay? Just stop being tricked by the parasites. Open your mind and your heart a little bit to this reality that we live in. This messed up shit show of a realm we live in. So here, pocket of survival here, and you can see the melt mainly at the bottom here. Usually the heat came from the bottom. So like a circuit board, the heat, the electricity is usually connected from the bottom. And I like to compare it that way. To me, it makes sense. To you, I don't know if it makes sense. Does it make sense to you? But that's how I do it. Just to have some kind of way to explain this that humans can understand, okay? So we gotta make up new words. We gotta compare it with something we can relate to so we can understand this. So that's why I explain it that way. I don't know if it was a circuit board like that, but that's what it looks like. And that's something most of us can relate to. So, you know, makes sense, right? And you can see here a wall here, and then suddenly turn into that, but it still has apertures in here, and there's some archways and apertures here as well. But yeah, you can see the melt here. Swollen, heat expanded, cooked out, lost the carbon red, carbon 14 red iron, whatever, so it turned white. This is a good one. So you see this structure still standing here while this got swallowed on here. Brick lines expanded here, swollen into block lines. And look at this shit. There's even an attempt to be some kind of arch and opening here, but it's not anymore. It's too swollen and, you know, what the hell is this doing here? I got another photo of the same place. Hold on. So yeah, it's swollen, expanded, and mangled up here. Here from afar. Look at this. It's just peeking out from the melt here. The stuff up here, you can see it remains a little bit. It's a little bit unclear back here. I've shown this in previous videos and stuff as well. So, you know, I recommend you guys, if you're new and stuff, and if you came this far into the video, then you're probably curious. So I'd appreciate if you leave a like and maybe subscribe if you would want to see more of my stuff. You know, I'm gonna start producing again after having a break, taking care of some stuff, etc. But so here you see another just a wall on the cliffside, pocket of survival here. You know, why would you do this stuff? So it's very mangled, obviously, and the whole structure is now a supposed mountain. One of these monasteries on a cliffside. So this is trees here. So it's a pretty high up, not too high, but a little bit high up from the ground that's down here somewhere. So I mean, imagine building this on that. Yeah. So you got pockets of survival. This one, rock curtained here. So, yeah, side of a cliff, basically. I mean, you wouldn't build there. Have you been in construction? The first thing you do, you level the ground. You're gonna put the fucking building on, okay? And here, I came across this one. So, 1865, someone came with a camera to Egypt, and they saw this in this condition. Okay, that's like 159 years ago or so. So they see it so buried, and they would call it sand. I call it brick ash. So the desert's dustified buildings, it's the last stage of the melt, so thoroughly cooked that it just dustified, it's turned to ash now, and that's sand basically. But whatever, so you come here 159 years ago and you see it in this condition. So this is now, and you can see this one is buried up to his arm in crap here, this one too, basically all this shit is buried up to here. So only 159 years ago someone came here with a camera in this condition. So to me that tells us that this was found around 159 years ago, that someone came there like, oh my god, take a look at this shit, you know. Because if not, you know, I think humans are curious enough about finding this somewhere 159 years ago, or 200 years ago, 300 years ago, 500 or 1,000, that they would dig this shit out. I mean, they would try to find stuff like, hey, what the hell is this, you know? Because they know they didn't build it. Who built it? And they want to figure this shit out. I think humans are curious enough. So to me, that tells us they found this recently, 159 years ago, which to me also tells us that this cataclysm I'm speaking of is also pretty recent. Maybe a couple of hundred years ago, and then the parasites, or you know, whoever did this, was it an accident, was it intentional attack to do this, or was it like a reset event that this realm is doing here and there? I don't know, but someone survived and they decided to take advantage of this event, start over with the bullshit narrative. So they came around, they had to clean up this stuff, come up with lies, etc. And then we came in from somewhere, somehow, and was introduced to all this infrastructure that was already built here. I mean, take a look at Italy and stuff like that, you know, these old cities. All that shit was already there. We did not build it, okay? So there is like, the mainstream narrative is like, oh, we built this shit like 1880, you know, whole cities from 1880 to 1892 or something, like 12 years, and then there's a huge ass city there fucking 150 years ago. I mean, it doesn't make sense, with horses and carts, and who were the educated builders and bricklayers and construction people and all that stuff at that time, and how many, you know, all that stuff. It just doesn't make sense. So, you know, that's my take on it. Just a little video for you guys. If you came this far, I appreciate it. Like I said, please leave a like and subscribe if you're curious and want to see more stuff that I'm gonna upload, you know, one of the days here and there and stuff. And you know, leave a comment if you have questions or stuff, or if you're like, oh yeah, you know, it makes sense or something. I mean, let me know, because it makes me a little bit happy when I can see other people gaining knowledge of the stuff that I produce and the content that I create and put out there and stuff. And, you know, let me know that you appreciate it. And, you know, if you think I'm a fucking crazy ass nutjob, don't even leave a comment, because I'm not gonna respond to it. I'm not gonna delete it, but I'm not gonna respond, because I don't care. This is my belief system. That's what it is. And it's up to you if you think it makes sense or not. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and also make sure you go down in the description box. There is a link there called linktree/meltology channels, and in there you should see most other content creators who speak of this, so you can see their narration and their evidence. People do boots on the ground, they go to these places, record it, explain it in their way, etc. It's good stuff on there, and you can see there's many of us, so all that good stuff. Okay, thanks for watching. Have a good rest of your day or night, depending on where the hell you're from or whenever you're watching this, or yeah. All right, thank you guys, and see you next time.